Hello. Hello, everybody. It's, what time is it? I don't even have my clock on. 10:50 p.m. Central Time, 17th of April, 2024. Hope you're doing well. Guys, got breaking news in case you haven't heard. It's been several hours, so I assume you've heard if you're into the geophysics world. The biggest volcanic blast of the year for the whole planet has happened over in the West Pacific in our warned area where we had the warning going for a large earthquake to strike. And so let me just show you where we're talking about over here. Right down here at North Indonesia at the S-shaped bend in the plate boundary, just south of the Philippines border. And if you paid attention to my forecast from 9 days ago, we issued the warning for South Philippines right here. And we talked about watching as far south as North Indonesia and as far north as North Philippines. And we have to go back. There was a deep earthquake that happened down below over here on the Izu Ridge on the Mariana Trench, a deep 6.8. This is like 9 to 10 days ago that happened. And it's in my video from 10 days ago now, international time. Go watch on my channel if you want to go see it from 10 days ago. There I am talking about the deep 6.8 earthquake here and then issuing two warnings. First warning was for up to a 6.5 to strike in Kyushu, Japan, South Japan. And the second warning was for a bigger event to take place down here in South Philippines going into the North Indonesia region. Now, Ruang Volcano just erupted. And it's absolutely massive. 55,000, first it's 63,000 feet. They have a troposphere warning that was issued. Then they took that down to 55,000, which is, I mean, just a little bit less. It's the biggest volcanic blast on the planet. And let's just go ahead and get Google Earth open here so that we can go look up the location in question. And let me also make sure you can see everything that I've got on the screen here. Okay, you can. Good. If you're not aware, oh, let's go get this open. Check it out. Look at the blast here. Hold on. Let's just get these. This is real. These are real videos. I'll mute it. But all you're going to hear is a guy starts talking and so forth. So, anyway. This is just insane. Look at the amount of static discharge. Now, what's happening there is there's actual friction between the rising heat, the ash going through the humidity in the atmosphere. It literally causes lightning, a lot of it. We've seen lots more in the past in other volcanic eruptions. There's actually been more than this, but this is phenomenal. This is huge in the amount of lightning that is going on. It looks apocalyptic because it is apocalyptic when you're talking about a huge 55,000 foot high blast with lightning and everything else coming out of it. This is the definition of something that people would have ancient times would have called apocalyptic. So it's not the end of the world, but it gives the appearance of such. So it is the biggest blast of the year. It kind of reminds me of maybe like Villarrica volcano in South America when it blew. But this is on the other side of the planet. Let's, again, just kind of fast forward through these. You guys can go watch the videos. I don't want to step on anybody's copyright. This is just video after video of it showing the different angles on this thing. It was, warnings were issued as far away as South Philippines. And this matters because I issued the warning for right here. So right in here is where we issued the warning for the big earthquake, a big seismic event to take place. That was based upon the deep earthquake on the other side of the plate boundary over here. Something coming up down below here, prompting me to issue the warning for Kyushu to be on watch for a 6.5, and down here in South Philippines going into North Indonesia to be on watch for the big seismic event. Here is Ruang. Wrong. Ring. You may notice it's shaped like a pentagon, sort of. That's just by chance. And here's our information. It's a regular eruptor over there. It happens every few years. It might get a semi-large blast, you know, 15,000 or something like that. So this is a big one, even by their standards. We were looking for a big seismic event in this area on the south side of the diamond-shaped plate here. You see it, of course. Deep earthquake there. prompting me to warn Kyushu and South Philippines. What happened in Kyushu? Today, just a few hours ago, Kyushu was struck by 6.4, well, now 6.3 if you go with the USGS. 6.4 earthquake, 6.3 struck at Kyushu several hours ago first. So first, check this one off the list. We warned them. It got hit. First large earthquake in Kyushu in months. And then down here is where we had the big warning going for seismic. Now, if I get the biggest blast of the year for the whole planet in the area where I issued a warning for the biggest earthquake of the year, at least in this area, for big size-wise, I will accept that as the seismic event we were looking for. I don't normally forecast eruptions, but there have been many times where I've issued a warning for a huge earthquake to strike a spot, and then that direct spot gets a 50 or a 60,000 foot high volcanic blast. If you're a viewer of mine over the last 10 years and you witnessed that with me, because I know there's going to be new people in here who just kind of don't believe that or whatever, that you've seen this happen before. I'll give you an example. I warned right here for a upper 7 to strike. So we warned right here for this week for up to a 7.8 to strike. I hardly ever issue warnings like this for huge earthquakes, like 8s and stuff. Never. Maybe twice a year we might do that. So here we are. This is an example. I issue a warning for an 8.0 earthquake to strike here at Papua New Guinea. A few days later, the biggest blast on the planet from a volcano that hadn't erupted in 10,000 years occurred right here in the middle of the arrow. Just as one example. So if I'm looking for a huge earthquake and we get a big blast in the area, I will check it off the list as being the hit we were looking for seismically. So I would think after this eruption, within the next several days, we will start to see a compensation that takes place along the plate boundary next to this. Let me show you the plate boundary so you can know what I'm talking about. It's going to move in the next few days. I mean, it's already moved, obviously, but we're going to see actual seismic after this. So you see the red lines here. You see where they go. Out of South Philippines and North Indonesia, they go down to the south, over to the east into Papua New Guinea, over to the west into Indonesia, to the north, goes back up to Taiwan that got hit last week with the 7-point-whatever earthquake. The biggest in their recorded history, or near second biggest, third biggest, one of the top in their history in Taiwan was last week. We had our deep earthquake over here on this side, and they're all connected. They all go back down to here and over to the west towards Europe, up to the north to Japan. So now that this volcano has blown here, huge, we should see shifting on the plate boundaries adjacent. This means north of Japan. This means south going west into Indonesia. And this means back over east, over into Solomon Islands. We should see seismic big time over the next week spread out from this location now. So over the next week, I'm going to have to get a new forecast out for the next 7 days. But just we can already start to watch for it. Going from here, down and around the bend, over to the west, following the arrows, and we can name our spots to watch. So the way we do this is we find our halfway points between our current sets of earthquakes. And standing wave principles apply. Simply put, think of this 4.7 on one side and this 4.8 on the other, like a two-arm scale. And we're going to find the middle point between the two. We don't just draw a straight line, though. We go along the bend of the plate here. So we have a quake here and a quake here, and the halfway point between them brings us right into this. And of course, that's East Timor. So, East Timor on watch, large earthquake, 6.5 plus, next 7 days. I'm going to determine that just based upon what's going up to Japan. Should also go around and out towards Indonesia. Second spot to watch. Both of these are going to be hit. Sumatra, Indonesia, same size, 6.4, 6.5, somewhere in that range. Third earthquake, 6.4 to 6.5. Striking back over here in the Solomon Islands. So that's three different sets of sixes. And then North Japan, Hokkaido. Well, actually, hold on. I adjust that. Yeah. Well, Kuril Islands going into Hokkaido right here. And that's going to also be 6.4 to 6.5. So it's going to be four significant earthquakes in the next several days spreading out from this location. That doesn't count what's going to happen in the middle here. So in the middle, I would call this a hot mess at this point. We have a bunch of earthquakes over at Taiwan with a 7. We have our deep 6.8 location over to the east. We just had our huge blast down to the south, and we're moving on the north side. North side of what? This. this whole thing is now shifted. In the last 2 weeks, let's recap. 7-point-something earthquake over in Taiwan. Deep 6.8 directly across over on the Mariana Trench. Huge, massive blast, the biggest in the year, right down here at Ruang. And up here to the north, 6 and another 6 on both sides of the plate boundary here in Japan. Like a giant diamond, it's moved on all sides. Now we're going to spread to the north, to the southeast, to the west. We're going to go out towards Europe. It's going to head up towards Kamchatka, Alaska. Hawaii should start to move this week again. We may even see with the big blast like this. Look, we got to keep a watch on the other volcanoes. I don't forecast volcanoes. But would you be shocked if there's a big flare-up at the volcanoes going across the Pacific after this? Look, one more time. How many thousands of miles is this? This is 500 miles right here. 500, 1,000, 1,500, 2. So let's just say 6,000 miles linear has moved across all parts of the plate boundary and then down below it as well. If you're just now tuning in, an absolutely massive eruption has occurred over in the West Pacific. I'm going to play it for you again just so you can see it. This has happened at Ruang, R-U-A-N-G volcano. This is real lightning, real time. It's not sped up. We'll see this kind of static discharge lightning from eruptions when the ash is literally punching its way up through layers of the atmosphere. So static electricity, like scuffing your feet across the carpet. But it builds up inside of the cloud and then discharges into the atmosphere. It's lightning. And it comes out of the clouds itself. It's just amazing what we're seeing here. It's huge. It's going to be on all the satellite feeds tomorrow. It's night right now. We'd get an infrared view at best. But in the morning, you should be able to see this thing spreading out. The people there have to be at least on watch. Luckily, this looks like it was blowing maybe in the direction out to sea. We'll find out in the morning on that as well. I wouldn't be surprised that these people had to evacuate who got the videos to begin with. Much love to the people over there. And now they, of course, are used to it because they live alongside of volcanoes. But even when it's this size, even the people over there, they start to get on their motor vehicles and their scooters, whatever, and ride and get away from it because they know you don't want to get caught in the cloud that descends off that. There isn't pyroclastic flow reports. There aren't any that I know of. I think this was more of a blast that sent the cloud up, out, and over body of water, which is good news. If any collapse did happen, we wouldn't hear about it if it was out in the ocean. So let's recap one more time, guys. We have to go back 10 days to our deep earthquake that was down below this side of the plate boundary over here, the diamond-shaped plate boundary. Here, deep earthquake first, prompting me to warn Kyushu and South Philippines on this side. And what I said 10 days ago in my video over on my channel here, see it says 10 days ago, it's got 153,000 views. In that video, I'm talking about this earthquake on the center of the screen here now. This is my video from 10 days ago. See it? 6.8. That's down below the plate. And I said 10 days ago, something's going to come up along these plate boundaries, and then it will strike a shallower, larger series of events. So the earthquake, look where the rings overlap in Japan from 10 days ago. Do you see how they both overlap on Kyushu? So the new earthquake, the new 6, popped off where those two sets of rings overlap now, 10 days later. The wave bounced around in here, going down and around and back up too, just bouncing around, back and forth, dropping off earthquakes along the way as it's trapped in here, trying to get out. The wave, the seismic wave that came up from down below, came up, went up this way, back down this way, and around and out towards Europe and back over towards Japan again. And the whole time that happened, it was like a sloshing standing wave in a tank. You can see the earthquakes over the past few days. Check it out. The pink colored earthquakes are from yesterday. The white colored earthquakes are from today. You can see it's gone out to Europe, dissipating as it gets as far as Poland. Goes back over and goes back up to Alaska, dissipating as it gets up to Alaska. That's in pink yesterday. Now today, we get our breaks in the middle and huge activity right down at the center of all of it. Because you got to remember, 10 days ago, something came up here and then vibrated up, out, and away, and back to itself, and then away. And as it goes back into itself, we're pumping more energy into the tank with new deep earthquakes. So it's standing waves. It's like a tank that starts with small ripples in it, and then it grows in amplitude, magnitude, and grows, and then the middle points between the previous waves are hit next. There's organization to this. It is not chaotic. So now that we understand that, now you understand how I came to the determination of where to watch 10 days ago, because the rings overlapped on Kyushu and the rings overlapped on South Philippines going into Indonesia. Now South Philippines and Indonesia has the biggest blast in the year for the whole planet, and Kyushu gets the biggest earthquake in months for Kyushu. Now that's just the West Pacific. We've got activity going on over on the west coast of the United States. We had to wait 9 days for this. So we did not get the earthquake off the coast of Oregon. I was looking for up to 6.0, 5.9 to strike off the coast of Oregon. And now on day nine, on the far north side of where I was watching, let me show you where we were watching versus where it got hit. We're going to jump all the way across over here to the Juan de Fuca fracture zone. And we'll go right into this giant arrow shape, or this sawtooth edge shape. This belongs to the Pacific. The sawtooth edge shape goes into the Juan de Fuca. We warned right out here for 5.9. What hit? It hit up here on the north side. And it's under what I was expected. So I'm how many miles off? 300 miles off and one magnitude off. It's on the north side of the Juan de Fuca instead of the south side. So why did that happen? Well, look where it is. It's the middle point between the two sets of quakes on down in the United States and up in Alaska. And I don't mean just random middle point. If you go look at the actual earthquakes, you'll see we're somewhat evenly distribution going. Earthquakes up here, earthquakes down here on the plate. In between the two, standing wave comes up and strikes there. 10 days ago, I thought it was going to strike here. The point is that the spot we were looking for, generally speaking, within 300 miles. I'm trying to get it down to 200 miles as my I can sign off and get out of here moment. When I get each location down to 200 miles, I'll feel like I'm the best forecaster in the world. Actually, I am, because everybody said it was impossible. Now, let's go down to the south and talk about this. Central America was struck. Costa Rica. Now, I did not save my live broadcast when I issued my warning for Central America. You'd have to have been live here on my stream last week when I was just going around the planet live and telling people where to watch. I didn't save it, and I didn't write it down. I'm going on memory, and I don't remember what I issued the warning for Central America. I'm pretty sure I issued two watches. One, well, I'm not pretty sure. I'm positive I issued a watch for Gulf of California to be on watch for 5.0 level activity. Fives hit 4.7 and 4.4. Down to the south, I don't remember who I warned. Was it Guatemala? Was it El Salvador? Was it Costa Rica? Dude, at that point, last week, with all the shutdowns and all the weird stuff that was going on and all the bad stuff, I just got on and did my update and just, I winged it. If you remember, you're doing better than I am, because I asked everybody over on my X page. Some people said, I think it was Guatemala. Well, let me show you where Guatemala is. Guatemala's right here, where the V is, and the earthquake hit right here at the border of Nicaragua and Costa Rica. The border of Panama. So that is the earthquake we were looking for. I'm positive it was in the 5.5 range that I issued the warning for. We'll accept as high as 6.5, so check it off the list. The other location, spot on hit, central Gulf of California. Hawaii, strikeout. I did not get it right in Hawaii. The earthquake, no earthquake of significant size above 2 point something, struck all week as far as I can see. Hold on. Am I right about that? Or did I miss something? Oh, wait, hold on. Just a 3. Yeah. I was looking for up to 5.0 over on the west side of Hawaii by Captain Cook. Nothing. Strikeout in Hawaii so far. Now, every other location has pretty much been hit. The only spot that didn't get hit was South America. We were looking for an extremely large earthquake to strike in South America, up to 7.4. Well, that's not extremely large. A large earthquake to strike in South America from Chile, right in here, right in the middle of Central South America. That's the central part of South America, not Central America. Anyway, we were looking there. No big earthquake hit there. But then again, I was looking over here for a large event to happen, and no event took place till day 9. And it was a 7 to 10 day watch. We're on the last day of the watch, on the extended part of the last day of the watch. 10 days as opposed to 7, right? So do I just need to give it another day in South America? I don't know. If we get to tomorrow and South America gets creamed, then I'll check it off the list. If not, I'm counting it as a miss. Ozzy! Guys, Australia, check it out. 4.2 earthquake struck down next to Adelaide. We had warned for a rare 4.5 plus earthquake to strike between Adelaide and Melbourne. So here we are between Adelaide and Kangaroo Island. Adelaide is right here on the peninsula. Kangaroo Island's right down here, this little island. And you got your 4.2. Additionally, 2.8 struck down to the southeast. Perth started to move down to the southwest, or by Perth, and out next to Exmouth, the VLF station that I showed you. All the spots got hit, guys. Oh, even the rare earthquake in Queensland got hit last week. 7 days ago, 6 days ago. Central Western Queensland, 3.1. But check it off the list if you were keeping track of areas that I named in Australia. There it is. East Coast United States. Let's jump back across the planet and talk about what didn't hit versus what did. Here we are. We are on day 9 of the watch. It's expired. It is not hit. We were looking for up to 5.0. A rare earth, 4.5 to 5, to strike at the South Carolina-North Carolina border region. Instead, 2. how much less is that? That's 1,000 times less power than I was looking for. 1,000. It's a miss. It's a miss. It didn't hit yet. Yet. I say yet because look at the rest of the locations that got hit. The only thing missing was our earthquake off the West Coast. So now that the West Coast has been hit today, I'll give it till tomorrow if we don't see a 5 in the East Coast on the East Coast. Do you consider this the east or southeast? South Carolina, North Carolina border region. If we don't see it by tomorrow, I will call it off. The warning. But all the signs point to it. Look at the last 3 days worth of quake. Look at the last 5 days. Let's get all the numbers out of here. So you should be able to see it. Fives and fours over on the West Coast. Threes going across to the plate over to the Midwest. Twos then spreading up the East Coast. And then ones. Ones going all the way up to the Northeast. See how there's a distribution up the East Coast almost perfectly like a wave spreading across a pond? The equal distribution on this. Now look at our halfway points between our earthquakes. One halfway point is right here, Vermont, New Hampshire. Down to the southwest, we're down at Virginia, going into North Carolina. So I've warned the North Carolina-South Carolina border area right here for the 5 to hit. It is a big open area between West Virginia and North Carolina-South Carolina border region that should be filled in with a new earthquake of significant size. Hasn't hit yet, so it could be a miss for me. I do get things wrong, just like the meteorologist when they're doing forecast. But you got to remember, this is 10 days ago. How accurate is the forecast from meteorologists from 10 days ago? We're talking about minuscule differences here, and we're waiting for 2 locations out of like 50 to get hit. Over to Europe, this is three locations to get hit. I was 2 magnitudes off in Greece and Turkey. Look at our magnitudes, add them together, goes up to 5.0. I warned Greece, Turkey for 6.5. So they got a 5. Total energy, that's a miss to me. Again, if I warn Turkey to Greece and they get 2 magnitudes under, I missed in the location. Today is the last day, technically 7 to 10 day watch. Today is day 10. The earthquake doesn't hit today in Greece, Turkey. I'm either 2 magnitudes off and that's a miss, or the earthquake didn't hit at all and that's the miss. So I do get locations wrong, but I am forecasting for the whole planet. But why didn't Europe get hit? And why hasn't South America been struck by anything significant? Look at the last 2 days in South America. 3 fours? That's it? Here's today. South America. Here's today, the rest of the planet. So tell me we're not missing activity down in South America that's going to strike. It's gone silent. It's like the calm before the storm. So like I said, if it gets to tomorrow and South America gets hit, if we get to tomorrow and Greece gets hit, I will count those as technical hits, but I have to figure out why it took 10 days instead of 7. Where did the wave bounce around? Why did the wave bounce around instead of striking? You can kind of see it Look at the last day's worth of earthquakes going over towards Europe, for instance. Or 2 days, really, will show it. It's like a stepping stone path. The pink earthquakes are from a day ago. The white earthquakes are from today. So pink earthquakes, look at them. See how they're in between the whites? The whites just struck today in between the pinks. The halfway points. And you go back to the start of the week, and it's the same thing all the way back. You see how it dissipates from fours down to threes as we go over to Europe? We go around the outside edge of Europe, and we're heading out towards Iceland. So the final step on this is for big earthquake activity to strike the North Pole to Iceland all the way out to the Azores. All three locations should get big earthquake activity this week. By the end of this week, we should be talking about big earthquake activity spreading to rare locations that we don't normally hear about, such as the North Pole and Iceland, where you normally get eruptions instead of large earthquakes. Europe, I'm going to keep watch till tomorrow. Tomorrow I will have my new forecast out for the next 7 to 10 days, where we will then keep watch for a new spread to take place, which I already told you about at the start of this update, which is the new spread is going to be spreading out from where our big blast just happened. Now, it's not the blast causing this. Let's rewind all the way to 10 days ago. The deep earthquakes from 10 days ago going into today that are raised high off the planet, those are the players. Those are what is the cause of the seismic wave that spreads out around the whole planet. Simply put, guys, there's something going on down below the plates, deep earthquake-wise, which then comes up and spreads out following these red lines. And if we know where something's coming up from, and we know ultimately where it's spreading out to, and we know the avenues by which it travels, then we can forecast like for a flood almost. Think of it like this. A big storm developed down below the plate 10 days ago here, which then came up and spread out following these red lines here and went over to Philippines and went up to Japan, and the wave that came up dropped off the earthquake in Japan and the eruption in Philippines as it's spreading up, out, and away. And it takes many days for this wave to bounce back and forth inside of an area before it goes out to the next area and drops off more earthquakes along the way as it tries to equalize across the whole planet, spreading out from where it came up from all the way to the opposite side of whatever it is, whether it's the opposite side of a sphere or a diamond or if it's flat. Yeah, get your attention, right? Hey, I got a little joke for you. You know why you can't see Planet X? Or Nibiru? They're so flat, you can't see them. Like one of those flying aerobie discs you toss in. It's just narrow, so flat. The profile on it, invisible. It's like a very fine samurai blade. Okay, all right. Oh, you like that? Here, hold on. I got a little cough coming here. Hold on. Okay. Let's get back to it. So the biggest blast of the year has happened for the planet. 63,000 feet to start is where they came in at. In case you don't believe me, I know there's going to be people who are like, what? Mainstream media didn't say 63,000? Well, I don't know what they're saying now. Let's go down and scroll down the list. See where it says FL550? 550, 550. Where did they start with the reports? Right here. FL630. And there it is. So I'll read the description to you. High-level volcanic ash emission observed on the Himawari 9 satellite image to FL630 at 17th of April at 1350Z, which is universal time. Volcanic ash appears to be reaching to tropopause or higher on satellite imagery. Volcanic ash expanding radially. Low confidence in forecast of surface to 52,000 feet polygon due to uncertainty and ongoing emission height. They didn't know how high it's going. It's dark. They don't have a laser altimeter to tell them how high it is, so they're basing it on the satellite. Okay. Simply put, huge blast. Starts out at 63, then comes out to 55. Let's go see what the media is saying. RUANG.
Ruang.
Oh, wow. Hold on. They've adjusted it. 70,000 feet now. Hold on. Hold on. This is from the Washington Post, the trustworthy mainstream media. Let me read it like the mainstream media would. Indonesia's Mount Ruang is... Okay, there we go. 70,000 feet. Possibly spewing aerosols into the stratosphere. The atmosphere's second layer. Thanks for clarifying that for us, guys. Not that anybody will even understand what that means. I don't even know what that means. I do, but just kidding. 70,000 feet, they've got it now. Okay, there it is. Hey... Who am I to disagree with the mainstream media? Well, if we go with the reports, it says 55. What's the difference? What's 15,000 feet between friends? Let's go back over and take a look at the earthquake activity one more time. Check Japan off the list. Hit spot on, first in months, and in this location especially, the biggest in months. And we warned them for up to 6.5, 6.3 to 6.4 struck. Down south, the biggest blast of the year for the planet. We'll accept that as the earthquake we were looking for. West Coast, I'm 100 miles outside of my 200-mile warned area. It's 300 miles north. Again, I'm warning here, and it hits here. I'm within the magnitude. That's the quake we're looking for. Took 9 days instead of 7. Or if you could say it took 9 days out of 10. My forecast was technically 7 to 10 days. If it strikes anywhere in that 3-day time period towards the end of the forecast... Okay, what else do we have to talk about? Well, I would like to talk about the West Coast, United States. Just really quick, I know there's been some professionals that have issued warnings for large earthquake activity to strike on the West Coast, but they didn't tell you where, did they? I mean, the West Coast is pretty damn big. If I just warned the West Coast, just said, hey guys, West Coast, do you think any of my professional haters would accept any earthquake that hits there if it's big? It would have to be huge. If I just warned the West Coast of the United States for like a 4 or 5, they would say that happens all the time, Dutch. You have to be more specific. So when they're talking about bigger earthquakes on the West Coast, that's the professionals issuing those warnings. And it got everybody panicked, like it's imminent. And so then you see swarms start to take place. You start to get worried. And that's when they start seeking funding. In case you didn't know, usually those articles... If you were to somehow get some kind of inside scoop at the colleges around town, around the West Coast, you'd start to see funding requests based upon these new articles that come out that say stuff like that. Now, I'll tell you, we usually have a warning ahead of time. The warning ahead of time is usually a day or two at least, and it's usually in this level right here. 5.0 starts striking off the West Coast of Alaska, Canada, Mexico, and we're sitting high and dry with no fives on the West Coast. Make note of the distribution of earthquakes. 4.8 up in Alaska, 4.9 to 5.0 on the coast of Canada, 4.9 down in the Gulf of California, 5.5, bigger of the bunch, down south, right? But look at the spacing. It's perfect, going around the bends of the plate for a distribution of a standing wave. So now we can find our next points to be hit. Here, Kodiak. Here, where is that? Lompoc, California. So Lompoc, California is next to be hit, as well as Kodiak, Alaska, as well as the Western Aleutians going into Kamchatka. All three should be hit by something like 4.9-ish. How do I know?
4.9 wave is already bouncing around there. You can see it. That these are the current earthquakes.
The distribution's perfect. So this wave is going down and bouncing in back into itself here. Let me show you where it's bouncing back into itself. How do I know it's bouncing back into itself? I guess would be the question, right? Let me show you what it's bouncing into. Well, hold on. Let me get a correct earthquake open from the USGS or something. What is going on here? Everything except for the USGS. Okay. So the wave is bouncing around right now between Alaska up here and all the way down to Central America, down here, where Costa Rica is. So between Alaska and Costa Rica, an equal distribution of earthquakes along this red line. Wait for them to see them again. They're all the same size within a hair of a point of each other. Going all the way down where it's bouncing back into itself. Where is it bouncing back into itself? from up here, down through the plate boundary, into the second plate adjacent to the Pacific, past the Cocos, into the Caribbean. It's reflecting back into itself here. So the wave's coming down, bouncing back into itself, strikes there, should reflect back into itself, and our halfway point should be filled in with new earthquakes of significant size. So that means south of the Bay Area, that's Lompoc, and halfway point between these two sets of quakes brings us in next to Kodiak. If you go around the bend of the plate, what would you say the halfway point is between this 4.8 and this 4.9 if we go around the bend of the plate? Right? Like a two-arm scale. You would find the middle point, the balance point, but it's not a two-arm scale. It's a standing wave. So these are two waves. And the new wave is going to come up in between them. Same with here. And we can carry on. Same with here. Central Mexico. The principle applies all over the planet. The halfway point thing. So here. Here. Going around the bend of the plate. Here. These are all going to get struck. They're all going to be struck by something bigger than what's on both sides right now. And it'll all happen in the next few days. It's the standing wave principle. It's huge to discover this. Professionals denied it. Whatever. All right. I'm showing you guys all so you can do it yourself. People told me I should have sold the idea. I said, well, you want me to sell it for $1 billion? Cash in on it? Really? Dude. You know how I'd get haunted by like every freaking ghost that ever died in an earthquake if I did that? You serious? No, man. Give it to the people for free. That's the way you do it. Galileo should have done it that way. Galileo, Tesla, the one mistake they all made is that they tried to cater the freaking system and present their discoveries to the authorities first instead of taking it to the people and dropping it at the people's feet and let the authorities pick up the pieces afterwards. That's what I did. I said, screw the Tesla approach. I'm not trying to get patents. I'm not trying to get their freaking approval. They said it couldn't be done. I did it. There it is. Everybody can repeat it. The step-by-step method is out there. You can do it yourself. And it's titled How to Forecast an Earthquake by Dutch Sense. So it's easy to find. I'm not trying to gatekeep anything. I'm not trying to make a buck on it. Speaking of making a buck, did you guys buy a t-shirt when I had one for sale? 100 t-shirts sold total. I made $5 a shirt, and I got to pay 25% tax on that. Not complaining. I'm one of the people who bought the shirt. I bought the shirt for myself. They don't give me one for free. Frickin' Teespring. Hey, guys. Old Man Dutch here to complain about t-shirts. Do you have an earthquake plan? How many people are in here right now? Let's go over and say hi to the YouTube audience. Let's remind everybody to like and subscribe my channel if you aren't. If you please do, I'm trying to grow the channel still. Please share it out to the world. If ever there's a disaster, I will be here when it relates to geophysics or weather. Guaranteed. Let's go ahead and see what we have on the screen here. Yeah, it looks like there's about 4,000 people in here. Sorry I get so fired up, guys, but this is a topic that I caught complete hell on for multiple years from professionals. It quite frankly ruined my life. I'm not kidding. But I'm not complaining. I did it myself. I stuck to science and went to prove my case and, you know, had the Galileo effect. But I would appreciate it if you would subscribe and share my information. That makes a big deal to me. Let's go in and say thank you to the people who gave. Thank you, thank you, thank you to everybody who's been part of the stream today. So let's just see what's going on. Viewer activity. Looks like somebody gave. Mary G. Mary G, thank you for the $10. And I can't see anything else. That's weird. Well, it'll tell me after the stream ends. But it says somebody gave $10. Thank you. And another person gave $9. $19.99. Thank you, thank you, thank you to my chat subscribers who super chatted me. I'll be back. I'm going to save this as a video, and we'll get it out over on YouTube for people to watch it back. One more time, if you want to know how to forecast an earthquake, I've put out the step-by-step method for anybody to test and repeat. For the people who are affected by the earthquake in Japan, for the people who are affected by the volcanic blast in Philippines going, or in Indonesia going into the South Philippines, you had a 9 to 10 day warning for this to happen. Much love. I'll be back. Peace out.